My people, I really don't understand African climb, why to date most of you burn down bushes perennially, meaning in every cycle of 365 days you burn down trees. You burn down bushes because you want to catch bushmeat. Question is, because you want to catch bushmeat, are you going to burn down the bushes and all the animals will not have habitat without grass for them to feed in and feed on one another in an ecological system? How do you think all other animals will be in existence? It's like, because you want to crush water from the ocean, you poison the ocean and all the fishes die. Tomorrow, what are you going to eat if all the fishes are dead? Don't you realize right from here I can hear electric saw, electric cutting machine cutting down trees. I'm very sure right here, because I don't know of a forest reserve around here, and I don't know the people lumbering those timbers are obviously illegal tree cutters or illegal businessmen cutting trees to do maybe roofing sheet, then bonfire, create charcoals and things like that. The truth is, we should realize we're part of the ecosystem. We're a living mud, but the tree too shares with us, because the oxygen we give out is what they take, and they give us back what we need. We need oxygen from them, which they create, and they take what we, our own exchange. You cannot take from nature without giving nature back, because at the end of it all, I'm saying capitalism is of course trying to rationalize, you know, redistribute income, and okay, realize that of every five different competency, there's different capacity to regenerate, because there's different creativity and different competency, different passion, different skills of communication and political will and even sense of direction and purpose. Vision sometimes is the mixture of what we call creating into existence what does not exist. That is only being done when you have the mental picture which could be dropped in from your competence, which is discovery from your creativity, irrespective of science. Science attempt to want to explain what nature is and relationship with the fact that we are all moving energies, and the energies which cannot be destroyed or created but can be transformed from one state into another. At the end of it all, we all strive. The most important thing, Brian Maslow was not insane when he talked about the hierarchy of needs. Hierarchy of need, basic needs are still the most fundamental principles and the foundation, which must be from ground zero. But as you move along the line, you discover it is the time you overcome those basic needs. At the height of its self-actualization, and there are some other parameters that are important. But until a man dies, anything is possible. But most of us have been conditioned to think anytime you see somebody, you've so conditioned your mind, it becomes so myopic that some of you, all you have is money. When you want to move around, you move in tinted glasses because you believe the man, the common man, there is downtrodden. Because you go to church, you go to mosque, or you go to shrine, you pray, you say, oh, you are safe. How safe can you be when the man lying on the road there is your brother? The woman lying outside there being beaten by mosquito is your sister. What am I talking about? That's the reality of life.